Hey guys, this is Uttam Singh from Solar Pivot Power. Thank you for tuning in. So this video is about Jackery Explorer 1000. I've had this unit for a couple of years, and for most part, it has served me really well. Now this is a little dated. They have some newer models with a lot more capabilities out now. I think the latest one is called the Jackery 2000, which is an expandable power station. But I believe this is still very widely used and it has been popular for a long time. So
basically, a Jackery Explorer 1000 combines a MPPT charger along with a lithium-ion battery, a battery management system, and of course a pure sine wave AC inverter. With the Jackery 1000 Explorer, I've heard this recurring theme about DC charging limitations, mainly when charging with two Solar Saga 100 watt panels. The charging tops out at about 115 watts. Naturally, the expectation is that when two panels are connected with Jackery's Y parallel adapter, one should get close to 200 watts of solar power. Well, I regularly charge Explorer 1000 in excess of 150 watts with solar. Do I have a unicorn system? So this is a quick Mythbusters video, Jackery edition, where we take a deeper look into whether this limitation is real. So let's start by looking at Jackery's official documentation. And sure enough, it says right here that the input is limited to 126 watts. But wait, it further states something about voltage current. Interesting. It can support a range of 12 to 30 volts, and this doesn't make sense. It has a range of 7.5 to 8.33 amps. I don't think that's the range. It probably means upper limit of current. Let's assume it's 7.5 amps. All right, guys, disclaimer time. Please don't try this at home unless you know what you're doing. All right, so here we have a regulated power supply connected to a power meter, and then the power meter is connected to an Anderson pole connector, which we can connect to the Jackery power station. And the purpose here is to simulate a solar panel with the regulated power supply. So we're going to start off with 18 volts, which is what a single solar panel, Solar Saga 100 watt panel provides. And let's connect the Anderson pole to the Jackery DC input. And this should, once the MPPT figures everything out, this should, be around 105, 106 watts, which is what we typically see at the most in direct sunlight with a single panel. So this kind of proves out the basic setup. And what we can do now is we can actually regulate the voltage going from 18 volts to 25 volts. And as we bump up the voltage, the MPPT will figure out what the current draw should be, and it should manage accordingly. So here we see is that it's kind of topping off at around 159 watts, and that's what I get even when I connect a solar panel, like a 200 watt solar panel, to the Jackery power station. So that, I think we're hitting the max limit. The max current draw that I've ever seen is right around 6 amps. So even though the documentation talked about 7.5, I've never seen that. All right, so let's just bring it down back to 18 volts. And, we can see voltage times current is power draw. And that's what we're seeing here. And let's do that cycle once again, taking it back up to 26 volts. Here we can see even when I tweak it further inch towards 27, it doesn't really make any difference. It tops out at about 158, 159 watts. That's the max power this Jackery DC input can take. So that has, basically proven it out with the power supply. Let's now head outside and do it in real world. Okay, it's about solar noon, so I've just laid the panels flat on the ground. I have a 200 watt solar panel connected to the first Jackery, And the second Jackery is connected to the Solo Sagas with a Y parallel adapter. And the first Jackery is getting consistently over 150 watts, whereas the Solar Saga connected Jackery kind of taps out at about 110 watts. And that's been fairly consistent.
So the next logical question is, can something be done about it? So that when we connect two Solar Saga panels with one of these Jackery Y parallel adapter cables, can we get more than 110 odd watts, which is, you know, seems where it taps out? And the answer is maybe. So in theory, if you wanted a power boost from two Solar Saga 100 watt panels connected using a Y cable, you would basically need something that's called a DC to DC boost converter. What these devices are designed to do is they take in a certain range of voltage and they put out a higher voltage. And, you know, they do allow some sort of regulation, both for voltage and the current. Now, the problem is these devices are notoriously inefficient, especially the cheap ones. They generate a lot of heat, and, you know, so you require heat sinks to dissipate the heat, and sometimes you even need to add an external fan if you're dealing with a lot of power. So again, this is possible in theory, something that I have tried and I've seen it work. But as I said, to make this into a commercial product requires more engineering. Okay, so it would really help me out if you leave down below in the comments about your interest in such a device. It would help me gauge, of course, your interest and also how prevalent Explorer 1000 and Solar Saga 100 watt panels are. So that's it for now. Thanks for tuning in. See you next time.
Oh, and one last thing. Our 25% off introductory offer ends on July 22nd. So if you're a solar panel user and you've had issues where the wind topples your solar panels over, please take a look at our solar stakes. They're available on Amazon, and you'll find a link down in the description below. Thank you.